I'll ask everyone to please remain standing while Kaitlyn Blakely sings the national anthem and Katie Storr says the Pledge of Allegiance.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets that glared, the bombs bursting in archive proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening, parents, teachers, honored guests, and soon-to-be graduates. My name is Michael Garrity. I am the senior class president. Tonight, we dedicate our class night to our classmate and friend, Jordan Sibley, who passed away on May 13th. Many of Jordan's organs and his corneas were donated so others could live and see the world through Jordan's eyes. For those of you who did not know Jordan, he saw the world through photography. A quote by Peter Adams summarizes Jordan. Photography is not about cameras, gadgets, and gizmo. Photography is about photographers. A camera didn't make a great picture any more than a typewriter wrote a great novel. Let us now observe a moment of silence in Jordan's memory. Thank you. Now I would like to talk to three groups of people. I would like to talk to the teachers, to the students, and to my fellow classmates. First, I'd like to talk to the parents of this class. I should talk to you first because you have put up with us the longest. We would not be here without your support and encouragement. We may never fully appreciate you until one day when we are sitting in your seats watching our children occupy our seats. Thank you for your wisdom and guidance. For being there for us here in the good times and in the not so good times. To the teachers, you have given us the tools for life and learning and provided inspiration and motivation. And now I'd like to address my fellow classmates. In 3 days, we will be graduating. We will soon be the newest alumni of Foxboro High School. It seems like the last 4 years have gone by in a flash. They've been fun, though. I feel the excitement of our upcoming graduation deep within me. Many of us are sitting here tonight wondering how are we going to make it until Sunday because we're anticipating the excitement of it all. High school may be ending, but the learning is just beginning. Our future holds great promise, and no one can hold us back. So tonight, we shall reflect on our past 4 years here. On this note, I welcome each and every one of you to Foxboro High School's Class of 2007 Class Night. I would like to call Chip Rodenbush to the stage.
I'm here to honor Miss Dolan, who is retiring this year, and Ms. Dolan dates all the way back to the Igo in first grade to teach our class. We were all lucky enough to have her as a teacher. This year, I had sculpture class with Ms. Dolan, and it was the funnest class I had all year. Every day, class was all the same. I would go to class, and halfway through, I would end up doing something I shouldn't be doing, and Ms. Dolan would threaten to kick me out of class. But the funny thing is, I just knew that she was too nice to kick me out. We were lucky enough to be the last class to have Ms. Dolan as a teacher, and she will be missed by everyone. On behalf of the entire class of 2007, I would like to thank Ms. Dolan for everything that she has done throughout the years at Foxboro High School. Is she here?
I would like to talk about Mr. Gibson. Mr. Gibson began teaching physical education at Norton High School in 1981. In 1982, he came to Foxboro and joined Coach Martinelli's coaching staff as an assistant coach until 1985, when he left to become the head athletic director at Norton High School, where he also became the head football coach and the women's softball coach. He later returned to Foxboro High School in the position of athletic director. Mr. Gibson, the class of 2007 is proud to give you a Super Bowl ring. You have done an outstanding job with athletics at Foxboro High School. The blue and gold will miss you next year. We've enjoyed having you as our athletic director. Good luck to you at whatever golf course you are at next year.
First, I would like to acknowledge Ms. Pat Kelly and Ms. Janice Johns, for without you, we would be locked out of this building.
I would like to honor Ms. Deb Anderson and Mrs. Eileen Warnett. And thank you for your continuous effort that you have put into our class.
We would like to thank Mrs. Ingrid Viventi and Mr. Joe O'Neill. We wouldn't have gotten through the college process without you. Who knew that applying to college would be so hard?
Next, I would like to acknowledge Mrs. Sneed. Thank you so much for all the time and effort that you've put into straightening out Mr. Theodos, and also for the countless hours you've put in to making tonight and graduation unforgettable for all of us.
I would like to thank Mr. Theodos, Mr. Heinrich, and Mr. Delaney. You all keep our grade in line. You always know all our favorite spots in the building between classes, and you're there all the time, and we appreciate it.
At this point, I would like to call Jen Krupski up to stage to acknowledge a teacher who has made an impact on her throughout high school.
Walking into room 222, first period on the first day of school, freshman year, I had no idea that the bond I was about to make would last for 4 years. nor did I expect that bond to be made with a teacher. Mr. Faulkner always finds a way to connect his students with his subject while connecting himself to his students. Always making sure he was right in with us, he learned about the history of our lives as we learned about the history of the world through his direct and hands-on teaching methods. The more I got to know Mr. Faulkner, the more he planted ideas in my head about attending Holy Cross, although our talks about their football team's record didn't exactly persuade me. In the end, I chose another college, but I appreciate his sincere help and still apologize every time I wear a Bates sweatshirt. Mr. Faulkner's love for learning about others is obvious since the history hallway is constantly clogged with students insisting, even waiting in line to speak with him. When passing by, he always has something to say, such as, hey, hey, you know it, or that upside-down salute. Even as department head this year, Mr. Faulkner never hid in his new office, but was in the same spot across from room 222 between every period among the students. Mr. Faulkner, you are the best-intentioned, most sincere teacher I have come across thus far in my education. I will miss our hallway talks and want you to know that regardless of the outcome, part of me will always be a Holy Cross crusader. Thank you for everything you have done for me and our school. As you always say, have a good weekend. Don't get arrested. I would now like to introduce Diane Duggan.
I am almost positive that every senior here has had Miss K sing in one class or another, whether it be protest songs, chorus, or music class when we had her in second grade. Some people have had the privilege of knowing her since first grade, but I have only been lucky enough to have her since seventh. My first class with her was when we put on the play The Music Man. It started out when we rehearsed for an hour each day during school. Then each small group would have sectionals after school once a week, which we all would look forward to immensely. Nearing the end of the play, we would have night rehearsals, sometimes lasting until 10 o'clock, and Miss Kaysang would make us feel like one big family that everyone was a part of and everyone was having a fun in. The play was a huge success, and all of that is attributed to her hard work and dedication to us. Some of my fondest memories are when Miss Kaysang would come to my house to pick up her son, Danny, from a night with his friends, and all the girls would drop everything they were doing and run to the front door just to see Miss Kaysang, even if it was just for 5 minutes. Once high school came, I signed up for chorus because I knew that first period was always first in the day, and that I'd rather sing in the morning than do math. Soon into my freshman year, it wasn't about not doing math, but more about the music. She taught us that music relates to everything in life and everything that we do, always. She pushed us to be better at whatever we were doing, but always to have fun while doing it. Responsibility, determination, and punctuality were just some of the things that she instilled in us, showing them by example. Looking back now, I realize how much she has helped each of us to grow as people and as musicians by being our teacher and our friend. Miss Kaysang, you will be greatly missed next year, but I know that you will do wonderful things in California, just like you have done here. At this time, I would like to introduce Ryan Morshed and Chris Redd to honor Coach Martinelli.
Those who know of Coach Jack Martinelli often refer to him as a celebrity. Though he does get his fair share of awards and media coverage, I don't think that celebrity is the right way to define Coach. Award-winning author Daniel J. Borson once said, "The hero is known for achievements, the celebrity for well-knowns. The hero reveals the possibilities of human nature, the celebrity reveals the possibilities of the press and media. Celebrities are people who make news, but heroes are people who make history. Time makes heroes, but dissolves celebrities." If you ask any student at FHS, this is how they would describe Coach. He's known for his many outstanding achievements as a teacher, a coach, and a role model, and also for his warm and caring personality. Coach would also be described as the hero of every member of the class of 2007, and he has made his mark in history here at FHS, and we will miss you whenever we think of Foxboro High School.
As a coach, we couldn't ask for anything more from Coach Jack Martinelli. He set our standards high, and he knew what we were capable of, and he pushed us every day to get to where we wanted to be. Although there were some bumps in the road midpoint of the season, he never let us stop believing. With the help of Coach Montanelli, we upset Mansfield on Thanksgiving and carried that momentum to win a Super Bowl. It's truly an honor to get Coach to his 200th career win and put another ring on his finger. We'd like to recognize Coach Jack Montanelli, not only as our coach, but as our teacher, our friend, and our mentor. Coach Jack Montanelli. Now we'd like to call up Molly Kaklutis and Adam Stock.
As a freshman in high school, beginning a new music program with a director of intimidating yet an incredible reputation seemed unnerving and overwhelming. Quiet and reserved, yet direct and sincere, Mr. Massey is an educator with a wealth of knowledge, experience, and compassion that the everyday young and insecure freshman is ignorant of. As new and clueless members of the Foxboro High School Music Program, we as all freshmen were unable to foresee the extensive and eminent impact of Mr. Massey's dedication and extreme devotion as a music educator on our musicianship, leadership, and moral values as human beings that will carry with us wherever the years ahead take us.
From the first day of high school, the mantra, excellence is paying attention to detail and working harder than everyone else, has been instilled in us as a means to motivate hard work and dedication. Mediocrity is simply unacceptable. As the high standards set forth by Mr. Massey, all students are taught extreme discipline and confidence as tools that can be transferred through all subjects in life. In addition, through these standards, Mr. Massey proves that anything is possible, as seen through the many musical opportunities and achievements created and demonstrated daily for his students. Without Mr. Massey's guidance, encouragement, and blunt reality checks, this year's jazz ensemble would never have been able to walk on the stage of Avery Fisher Hall in Lincoln Center and perform with Wynton Marsalis. Even more so, Mr. Massey teaches his students that music is not about the awards or trophies, but the aesthetic experiences shared as a musical family, which all of us in the music program have experienced. Despite the many music festival experiences that Mr. Massey involves his students in, he is not a teacher who defines himself by the awards, but instead by the preparation and learning process. Because of the standard of teaching, each year Mr. Massey handpicks music that will challenge his current students to a higher level of achievement.
In addition to creating nurturing musicians capable of performing with poise and expressiveness, Mr. Massey produces leaders of the highest quality. His own qualities of intense punctuality, organization, and devotion set the example for student leaders throughout the whole music program. He has created an environment in which the upperclassmen go out of their way to help the younger and less experienced students succeed. This is surely something that does not happen in most schools.
Furthermore, the past 4 years in the music program have taught Adam and I that Mr. Massey is not the intimidating man that we once perceived him to be. He is an educator, musician, mentor, friend, father, and most of all, a good person, whose high standards not only produce excellent music, musicians, and leaders, but excellent people. It is because of his great compassion and love that he shows for all of his students that we love him. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to call up Tim Keefe, who will be honoring Mr. Murphy.
I wanted to acknowledge Mr. Murphy tonight because he's really had a great impact on the last 4 years of my life, and I know that every one of the seniors sitting here has had at least some experience with Mr. Murphy over these last 4 years, and even before that while he was a teacher at the Ahern. He served the students here in numerous capacities. He's a teacher, he's a track and cross country coach. He's pretty much always just someone there that you can go talk to when you're having problems. Whatever someone needs, that's what Murph's gonna be for him. He always knows on Monday morning what happened over the weekend, mostly because kids trust him. They'll come to him when they're in trouble or they're having problems at home or in school. He always knows the right thing to say and the right advice to give. I personally have had experience with Murph as my teacher, coach, my peer leader, advisor, my grandfather's neighbor, and a pretty good friend of mine. I could say without a doubt that my athletic career has been greatly enhanced by Mr. Murphy's leadership. And not only that, but my life. I wouldn't be the person I am today were it not for Mr. Kevin Murphy, or as everyone knows him, Murph. I'd now like to welcome Jen Contoy to the stage to talk about Mr. Roy.
When asked to speak about a teacher tonight, I instantly knew who I could speak volumes about. This teacher has been more than a mentor to me over the last 4 years. His aesthetic eye and artistic ability are unlike anyone else's I've ever met. Everyone has seen his work, whether you realize it or not, be it a sculpture, painting, poster, website, movie, drawing, or photograph. Yeah, he's pretty talented. Mr. Roy's ability to bring out not only the best in all of these fields, but his students' best is what truly makes him a remarkable teacher. I know from having for 5 full-year classes in 4 years, figure that one out, that his drive for teaching comes from the fact that he is helping someone pursue their creative ambitions. The look in his eyes when he stumbles upon a brilliant piece from someone who some would call a not-so-brilliant person is unlike anything you can imagine. He feeds off the creativity of his students, the fact that a student is pouring his heart and soul into the page. My freshman year, he saw that creative ambition in me and told my mother that as long as I kept my grades up, I would have no problem following my artistic dreams. I knew from that point on there'd be no slacking off. As my years went by, my bond with Mr. Roy grew stronger, as he began helping me not only with my grades, but with family issues and friendship tiffs. As senior year rolled along, he helped me more than I could ever imagine. He wrote me letters of recommendation, photographed my portfolio, and kept up my spirits with words of encouragement as things went rocky with the college of my choice. In the end, I am going to my top choice college, and on my way to becoming a graphic designer, all of which would be nowhere near possible if it was not for his help and guidance. He's been my safety net all throughout high school because I knew I could always count on him to help me with that last minute project or criticize that one detail that always reminded me to strive for perfection. Though I won't have him for a teacher next year and my net will be clipped, I know that the knowledge he has instilled in me and the courage to follow my heart will carry me through the toughest times next year. I know that there's nothing I can do to thank him for all that he has done, but say thank you and hope that it echoes 1,000 times over. So thank you, Mr. Roy. Your actions and words will not be forgotten. I'd now like to introduce Jess McAllister to talk about Senorita.
Four years ago, if anyone had told my friends that I was expected to speak at class night, they would have laughed. And if anyone had told me that, I would have cried. I was so shy that I only spoke when a teacher called on me, and even then I'd whisper an answer. But something changed when I met my student advisor, Senorita Smith. She believed in me when I didn't believe in myself. She valued my opinion, showing me that what I thought really did matter. Senorita gave me the confidence to stand up for what I believe in and proved to me that everything I do makes the difference. Senorita has always been dedicated to improving the lives of others through student council. She constantly motivates us to challenge ourselves, to do our best, but most of all, to motivate others to do the same. She honestly is the ideal advisor because she does just that. She advises. Senorita would never tell us what to do or how to do it, but rather she advises us in every way that she can, giving her best advice, asking us questions, but ultimately leaving decisions up to us. She believes that if we do not own our ideas, then they will never be as successful as they could be. Whether it was keeping a drawer full of snacks for late night meetings, surprising our executive board with their own t-shirts, or putting on a skit for our entire student council, Senorita always knew how to put a smile on our faces. This year, at the annual State Student Council Conference, Senorita won the 2007 Massachusetts Associations of Student Council as Advisor of the Year Award. This prestigious award is given to only one advisor from our state per year. Senorita, I know that you are most deserving of this award because of the countless hours of extra effort, time, and energy that you put into improving the lives of others. Thank you, Brooke, for being a constant support system throughout mine. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Theodos.
Good evening. On behalf of Superintendent Dr. Jan Norton, members of the school committee, administration, faculty, and staff, I would like to offer our congratulations to tonight's award winners and to all our soon-to-be graduates of the class of 2007. It's a pleasure for me to be part of the ceremony tonight. So to continue with the awards, as tradition would have it, I would like to recognize two individuals who have academically distinguished themselves for 4 years. Our first recipient, our valedictorian, Kara Deedy. Kara, come forward. Kara has been a member of the student council for 4 years at Foxboro High School. She was the class representative and treasurer in her freshman year. Once on the executive board of the school council, Kara was the board secretary in her sophomore and senior year and treasurer in her junior year. Kara is also a member of the National Honor Society. While at Foxboro High School, Kara was awarded the Bosch and Lomb Science Award, the Mass Association of Superintendent Certificate of Academic Excellence Awards, as well as the History, Biology, and Spanish Academic Excellence Awards. Kara is a member of the Massachusetts State House tour guide team. She's participated in the Relay for Life and the Jimmy Fund Theater Collection Program. She's been awarded the Great Trek Scholarship and the Navy Supply Corps Scholarship, and she'll be attending Boston College in the fall. Congratulations, Kara. The class salutatorian, Everett R. Tripp. Everett is a member of the National Honor Society. He has been awarded the Mathematics, Science, English, French, and Computer-Aided Design Academic Excellence Awards, and was also awarded the Brown University Book Award in his junior year. Everett is an Eagle Scout and a member of the Outdoor Club. He ran spring track and was a member of the Foxboro Warriors football team. He was the recipient of the MIAA Student Athlete Award. He was the recipient of the WPI Academic Scholarship and also the Great Trick Scholarship. Everett will be attending Worcester Polytechnic Institute in the fall, where he will study robotic engineering. Congratulations. Shannon, what do you mean Miss Sneed has to put up with me? Next, there are Student Leadership Awards. President Michael L. Garrity. Michael has been the class president for 4 years. He's been a member of student council for 4 years and was inducted into the National Honor Society in his junior year. He was a representative for Student Government Day at the State House in his junior year and a member of Model Senate for 2 years. He is very involved in the FHS Student Council. He's been a member of the peer leadership for 2 years, Students Against Destructive Decisions for 2 years, and the Best Buddies program for 2 years. Co-president of the Foreign Language Club for 4 years, secretary of the Multicultural Club for 3 years, and the History Club for 4 years. He has participated in the Walk for Hunger and was a team captain for the American Cancer Society Relay for Life for 4 years, and was a cable 8 television cameraman for 2 years. He was involved in our athletic program with our freshman basketball team and was captain of the JV basketball team. He's run cross country for 4 years, spring and fall track for 2 years, and varsity lacrosse for 1 year. He has received the National Society of High School Scholars Award, the Daughters of American Revolution Award, the dedicated awards for cross country and track, MVP for student council, Presidential Award for Fitness, and FHS Warrior Pride and Most Spirited Award. Michael is also awarded the Gray Trek Scholarship and was a recipient of the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship. He will be attending Providence College in September, studying political science. Congratulations. Our Vice President, Charles Chip Roddenbush. Chip has been the Vice President of his class for 4 years and a member of the Student Council for 4 years. He's also been in the Foreign Language Club for 2 years and Best Buddies program for 1 year. He's been a member of the golf team for 4 years, the baseball team for 4 years. He has won the MVP JV Baseball Award and the Most Improved Player in Golf. He received the FHS Golf Team Scholarship. He received the Student Council Unsung Representative Award and the Number One Fan, the School Spirit Award, and the Friendliest in the Class Award. He is you ever see him not smiling? He's always smiling. Chip has volunteered as a CCD assistant at St. Mary's Church and was a member of the Life Teen as well. He will be attending Bridgeton Academy in September, where he will study political science or sports broadcasting. Chip, congratulations. Secretary Katie Storer. Katie was our class secretary for 4 years and a member of the student council for 4 years. She was a delegate on the executive board of the student council in her senior year, peer leadership and students against destructive decisions for 2 years, and on the yearbook staff for 4 years. Katie has played basketball for 3 years, track and field for 3 years, and volleyball for 4 years, where she was captain her senior year. Katie is a Norwood Hospital junior volunteer and a CCD religious education teacher at St. Mary's, as well as a Jerry Lewis telethon volunteer. She is a member of the Massachusetts and National Association of Student Councils and the Southeastern Massachusetts Association of Student Councils. She has been awarded the Captain's Award and the MIAA Sportsmanship Award, both in volleyball, Most Valuable Student Council Representative for 1 year, and the Students Council Unsung Representative for 3 years. She was also awarded the Jane Brocas Leadership Award. Katie will attend Assumption College, where her goal is to major in organizational communications. Congratulations, Katie. Treasurer Shannon Flaherty. She meant no harm with the comments. Shannon has been our treasurer for the class of 2007 for 2 years. She is also a member of the Foreign Language Club for 2 years and Peer Leadership Club also for 2 years. She has volunteered at St. Mary's Church instruction for CCD for 4 years and has taken dance classes for 15 years. Shannon was awarded the AFL-CIO scholarship, and she will be attending Franklin Pierce College in September. Shannon, congratulations. President of the Student Council, Jessica McAllister. Jessica was inducted into the National Honor Society and was the National Honor Society's co-secretary in her senior year. She was in the book club for 4 years, the history club for 3 years, the foreign language club for 4 years, peer leadership and students against destructive decisions for 2 years. Jess has also been a member of the Student Council Executive Board for 4 years not only as president, but also as e-board publicity coordinator, e-board historian, and e-board delegate. She has been a volunteer at Norwood Hospital, a CCD instructor at St. Mary's Church, and has danced at the O'Brien School of Dance for 15 years. She has won the Best Attitude Award, the MIAA Sportsmanship Award, both in gymnastics, and has received the Caritas Norwood Hospital 50-Hour Volunteer Award. One of her very special gifts to the American Cancer Society was a donation of her long hair to the Locks for Love campaign. Jessica received a trustee scholarship from Salve Regina University, which she will be attending in the fall. Jess, congratulations. At this time, I'd like to call on Mr. Greg Woodward, advisor for the National Honor Society, for the next presentation.
Good evening, and congratulations to the class of 2007. 6 or 7 years ago, a young man passed through my classroom door named Kevin Krupski. And we got to have quite a relationship, a really nice bond. I ended up having him about 3 times before he graduated from this building. And a lot of times he stayed after school, we'd talk about this and that. And his conversation was often peppered with talk of his little sister. And the affection that he had for her was apparent from the very beginning. He talked about what a special person she was and how much she meant to him. Well, time moves on, and now we're 6, 7, 8 years past young Kevin Krupski, and what do you know, here comes Jen. It's been my privilege to be an advisor to National Honor Society here at FHS, and it's been a real privilege to have her as president. She's made my life easier with her organization, her energy, her brains. She's the complete package, and it's really easy to see what her older brother saw in her so many years ago. So, Jen, I appreciate everything you've done for me. Thank you.
The Principal's Leadership Award. The recipient of the Principal's Leadership Award program has demonstrated ability to combine academic excellence and exemplary leadership roles in school and community activities. The recipient of this award is Mr. Matthew Lee Carlson. Massachusetts Secondary School Administrators Association Student Achievement Award. This award is presented by the Massachusetts Secondary School Administrators Association in recognition of outstanding contribution to the school. This year, I am proud to present it to the President of National Honor Society, Jennifer Marie Krupski. At this time, I'd like to call in our assistant principal, Mr. Joseph Heinricher, for the next presentation.
Thank you, Mr. Theodos. My first award is from the Daughters of the American Revolution Award. The National Society of the Daughters of the American Revolution certifies that Michael Garrity has been selected as the DAR Good Citizen of Foxboro High School for the current year, having demonstrated the qualities of dependability, service, leadership, and patriotism. Michael? My favorite award to give out is this one here, Best Buddies Award. The Best Buddies is dedicated to enhancing the lives of people who have intellectual disabilities through one-on-one friendships. It takes a great deal of maturity, commitment, and dedication to be involved in Best Buddies friendship, and Caitlin and Tim have gone above and beyond the expectation. Caitlin's selfless service to her school community and Tim's dedication to helping people with disabilities should be applauded. Tim Keefe and Caitlin McGuire. Salve Regina University 2007 Trustee Scholarship awarded to Jessica McAllister in recognition of academic excellence at Foxboro High School. Jessica. The University of Maine is proud to award Dean Scholar Award to Kathleen Maureen O'Hara for academic year of 2007-2008. And Lisa Bolgan has won the History Club Award. Now I'd like to introduce the director of our art department, Mr. Jerry Roy.
Good evening. I'd first like to congratulate on behalf of the art department, the class of 2007. And I'd also like to congratulate the parents, because without you people, our job would be much more difficult. The first award for academic excellence in the visual arts is presented to a very interesting young man. He started his career in the visual arts at Foxboro High School a little late, but his exceptional talent, creativity, and intelligence has served him very well in a short period of time. He will be sorely missed. He's going to continue his visual arts education at UMass Dartmouth in the fall. He is a Boston Globe Scholastic Art Award winner, receiving a gold key in this year's contest and competed on a national level in New York City. It gives me great pleasure to present this award for his outstanding talent. And the only thing bigger than his talent and his creativity is this young man's smile. Because when he smiles and walks in a room and laughs, it lights up everybody in the room. I am very proud to present this award to Eric Lawrence Jr. The next award has been affectionately called at the beginning, about 6 years ago, the Pink Shirt Award. And there's a long story that goes along with that, and I won't bore you with it now. It's the Computer-Based Advertising Design Award, better known as CBAD. This award goes to a very special person, and I can think back and remember her freshman year sitting in my computer class and turned around and looked at me and said in all seriousness, "Mr. Roy, I'm going to win the CBAD award when I'm a senior, and I'm going to pursue my goal and dream of doing computer design and art on the college level." Well, both dreams have come true. This young lady will receive this award, and she will continue her dream of becoming a graphic artist and an artist at the University of Delaware next year. This is the type of person that whenever I needed something, somebody would come to me and say, "We need this poster, we need this logo, we need a design." She was always there, and I would always call on her, and she would always pick the ball up and run with it. Very successful young lady, gives me great pleasure, and I'm going to miss her an awful lot. to present the CBAT Award to Jennifer Contois. And my last award is a special award. As the art department grows and progresses, we keep trying to add new things to stimulate the young people. And we're embarking on a journey into digital video editing and production. This young man excels, plain and simple. He always would ask me, "Mr. Roy, how do I get to the next level?" Well, I said, "Come on over here. I'm gonna try to explain that to you. Take this software package, which some of you might know is called Final Cut Pro, and see what you can do with it." He took that package, learned it, excelled with it, and has produced countless videos. I looked at him one day and said, "Dan, you made it to the next level." It gives me great pleasure to present a very special award to a very special young man for his efforts for me and for the art department. For excellence in digital video editing and production, it gives me great pleasure to present it to Daniel Brooks. The next award will be presented by the head of the business department, Mr. John McCabe.
Good evening, everyone. Congratulations to the class of 2007. It's been my pleasure to have many of them in class over the years. One definitely stands out. He's definitely taken the most number of business classes, and he would have taken all of them if all of them had actually run. Some of them didn't run because of enrollment numbers, but he always came to class with a smile on his face, willing to learn, willing to help others, and that's why I'm proud to present this year's Business Award to Luis A. Perez, Jr. And now from the English department, Ms. Kathleen Keene.
Good evening. Congratulations to the class of 2007 and parents. We in the English department wish the graduates your very best next year and for every year in your future. The Medallion Award is given to a senior who has demonstrated not only excellence in academic achievement, but also a sincere interest in the subject through consistent and superior performance in class and in all activities or assignments. Each year, it's very difficult to choose just one candidate among the many who have achieved honors and who have participated in a positive manner to the learning process throughout high school. So as a result, this year, we have chosen two students to receive this award. And on behalf of all the English department at Foxboro High School, I have the privilege to announce that the Medallion Awards in English for the year 2007 are presented to Carter Davis and Everett Tripp. Thank you. The next presentation will be from Mr. David Watkins, the chair of the mathematics department.
On behalf of my colleagues in the mathematics department, we wish to congratulate the class of 2007 for all of their accomplishments. The winner of the Math Medallion has one of the most comprehensive mathematics resumes in the history of Foxboro High School. He has taken and excelled at 5 mathematics courses in his 4 years at FHS, including 2 advanced placement courses. Last year, he earned the highest possible score on his advanced placement statistics exam. This year, he earned an A+ for all 4 terms and on his final exam in advanced placement calculus. Also, during this past year, he elected to engage in an independent study program in higher mathematics. His culminating research paper was entitled Applications of Fractals and Chaos in Biological Systems. He is a highly intuitive problem solver who will be solving problems next fall at Duke University. The winner of the Award for Excellence in Mathematics is Mr. Ian Ballard. I would now like to introduce the Director of Music, Mr. Stephen Massey.
Good evening. Congratulations to the class of 2007, especially all the students who we worked with daily in the music department. You're all very special to us. The music department would like to recognize 2 outstanding seniors for excellence in music and excellence as people, Mr. Danny Kasang and Ms. Molly Kakloudis. Pleasure to introduce Mr. Paul Charpentier, the Science Department Chairperson.
Good evening. The recipient of the Senior Medallion for Excellence in Science has completed 6 science courses at Foxboro High School, including both AP Biology and AP Chemistry. This student is the only member of the class of 2007 to complete both of those courses. Needless to say, she excelled in all 6 of them. This student will be attending Boston College next fall, and when we last spoke, she had not yet selected her major. I thought science might be a good choice. On behalf of the science faculty, it gives me great pleasure to present the Senior Medallion for Excellence in Science to Kara M. D. For our next presentation, I call upon the Department Head of Social Studies, Mr. Donald Faulkner.
Congratulations to the class of 2007. The Social Studies Department, after due consideration and discussion, is going to give out 2 well-deserved senior medallion awards this evening to Brittany Madden and Matt Carlson. Flaherty, Technical Education.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Technology Education Department is honored to be part of this evening's celebration. To the class of 2007, congratulations to all of you and all of your accomplishments. This year's Senior Medallion Award is being presented to a student who, over the past 4 years, has maintained an A+ average in 4 various computer drafting courses, which is not an easy feat. In September, our award winner will be attending Worcester Polytech Institute, majoring in either computer science or engineering. Please give us a hearty round of applause for Jeremiah Buckingham. Our next award will be presented by Mr. Kevin Murphy, Director of Wellness and Family Consumer Affairs.
Good evening. First, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2007. To say the least, you were very exciting and you will be missed. Good luck. I have one wellness award for senior. It's not his first time to come up here. I believe he's repeated this all 4 years. Brian M. Johns. Also, I've had the opportunity to coach Brian in indoor and spring track, and he's been a great addition this spring after coming over from lacrosse. He was a leadoff leg on the Ben Harris, Sean Geary, and Tim Keefe Class C 4x8 relay that won the state title. So, Brian, come on up, please. It's also my pleasure to give out two awards for Family and Consumer Studies. Two girls that have done an excellent job this year. Mrs. Loftus was not able to be here tonight, but she had nothing to say about great things. Lauren K. Chambers and Chelsea N. Randall. My pleasure to introduce the Department Head of World Language, Mrs. Barbara Eaton.
The World Language Department is very pleased to congratulate all the graduates tonight, and we are also proud to give two senior medallions. The first one goes to Leticia Ciccone, who showed extraordinary commitment to foreign language by studying French, Spanish, and Latin, and maintaining excellent grades in these courses. And the second award goes to Matt Capone, who consistently maintained excellent grades in Spanish and showed a true commitment to learning the Spanish language. Congratulations. I'd like to introduce Mrs. Patty Martin, yearbook advisor.
This is my second year here as advisor for the yearbook. And I've had the pleasure of working with and getting to know just about every single one of this amazing class of 2007. I'd like to take the opportunity to congratulate each and every one of you on your graduation and wish you all nothing but the best as you embark on your future endeavors. I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce our senior editor for the 2006-2007 yearbook, Jen Contois. Jen, if you could join me, please. Jen, along with an extremely large group of students, have put together what we hope is a special memento of your time here at FHS. Will the following students please stand and be recognized, as we really appreciate all your help in putting the yearbook together. Chip Roddenbush, Cara Deedy, Jillian Conroy, Jen Krupski, Jenna Carcitti, Chris Redd, Ryan Morshed, Mike Pine, Katie Storer, Ryan Smith, Lisa Bolgan, Justin Thomas, Molly Clack-Lutis, Danielle Brown, Ryan McKeon, Melissa Wolfert, Tom Orlandi, Drew Connolly, Lauren Chambers, Kylie Quadrozzi, and Adam Stock. If I've forgotten anyone, I sincerely apologize. Thank you all very much. Could we please have Coach Martinelli and Jen Krupski please join Jen and I on the stage? The class of 2007 has dedicated this year's yearbook to Coach Jack Martinelli.
Okay, so one day around at lunch, we polled the senior class and asked them if he would dedicate the yearbook to anyone, who would it be to? And it was unanimous, it was all going to Coach. So we had Jen Krupski write a paragraph, and I'm going to read that for you right now. Our years at Foxboro High School would hardly have been the same experience if it were not for the efforts of Coach Jack Martinelli. Whether he was your teacher or your coach, whether you were shyest or most outgoing, Coach took the time to get to know the entire school, respecting each student for exactly who they were. In turn, the students gave their respect back to Coach, making him one of the most popular teachers to walk the halls of Foxboro High School. Coach has made a lasting impression on our school and our lives, and we will forever be grateful. We are proud to dedicate the 2006-2000 yearbook to Coach Jack Martinelli for his endless support for each and every one of us. Jen, stay here.
Class of 2007 has also chosen to dedicate the last page of our yearbook to Jordan.
I'll take over. Jordan was an amazing young man, and I had the pleasure of working with. I heard about his photography talents from some of the students, and I asked him to help us with the yearbook. He came to see me often and asked what he could do to help, and I quickly realized what an asset he was to us in the school. I remember a time on the pep rallies when he was running around the gym holding firm onto the camera on his neck and looked back at me and gave me the thumbs up, indicating that he had captured exactly the right picture he had in mind. He was always very excited to share his pictures with me, and we'd sit and review them and reminisce about what was going on at the time the picture was taken. For example, the downpour and the freezing temperatures at a football game, or the excitement in the air at the Super Bowl. He was an extraordinary young man and would be greatly missed by all who knew him. We'd like to present his parents with a special gift. If you could come up here now, please.
I'd also like to thank two other very, very special people with whom, without their help, I don't think I'd be standing here right now. Eileen Warnat and Drew Connolly, if you could please join me on the stage. Without their help, like I said, I would not be here right now. I'd now like to take the opportunity to introduce Elizabeth Greeley, Student Council President of the Class of 2008.
The The Foxboro High School Student Council would like to recognize this year's recipient of the Mr. Guy Annual Sportsmanship Award. This individual has participated in football, winter track, and was spring track captain this past year. His football coach described him as one of the hardest working kids ever at Foxboro High School, one who has overcome adversity and has played by all the rules. His track coaches believe that this individual represents true growth as an athlete, a student, and a sportsman. They also believe that he has improved tremendously in track over the past 2 years due to his dedication and work ethic, and sets a fine example as a role model. This year's Mr. Guy Sportsmanship Award is awarded to Jordan Kayani. Congratulations. I'd like to introduce Mr. Keith Gibson and Captain Christine Horst.
Good evening. I too would like to offer my congratulations to the class of 2007. It was a spectacular year athletically. Not only did we go on and capture the Division II Super Bowl in the fall, our cheerleaders also went on in February and gained national recognition at their competition in Florida. We had two state champions in the class meets, our 4x100 boys relay team and our girls 4x100 team. And please join me in wishing our baseball team good luck tomorrow as they compete in the South Sectional semifinals against Oliver Ames at Rockland High School tomorrow. I do have several awards to give out, so bear with me. I'll try to make this as quickly as I can. My first award tonight is the United States Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award. This award is given to a student who distinguishes himself in the true meaning of ability, courage, and determination. Our male recipient this year was the captain of the football team. He was named the Hockomock League and Sun Chronicle League All-Star team. He was a member of our basketball team. He is captain of the baseball team and was selected as an Hockomock League All-Star in baseball. Next year, he will be attending Curry College. Our male recipient for the United States Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award is Kevin McCarthy. Our female recipient of the United States Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award was a member of our girls' soccer team. She was a member of our winter and spring track team and would have competed in the 50-yard dash, the 4x200, the 100 meters, and the 4x100 relay team. However, injuries caused her not to be able to compete this year. But in spite of that, she still maintained regular attendance at practice every day, helping out our coaches with timing, attendance, and all the clerical work that goes along with coaching. So it's with great deal of pride that I award the female recipient of the United States Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award to Jenna Carcitti. My next award is United States Army Reserve National Scholar Athlete Award. This award is given to a male and female athlete who demonstrate outstanding performance on the playing field and in the classroom as well. Our male recipient this year was a member of the golf team. He was captain of our basketball team and was selected as a Hockomock League and Sun Chronicle League All-Star and was selected by the Mass Baseball Coaches Association as their scholar athlete. and he is also a member of our baseball team and pitched a great game yesterday. He'll be attending Tufts University. Our male recipient this year for the U.S. Army Reserve National Scholar Athlete is Eddie Bernstein. Our female recipient was captain of our field hockey team, a member of our lacrosse team, a member of the Student Council, National Honor Society, and is our class valedictorian attending Boston College next year. Our female recipient for the U.S. Army Reserve National Scholar Athlete Award is Cara Deedy. My next award is the Massachusetts Interscholastic Athletic Association Outstanding Scholar Athlete. This award is given to a student athlete whose performances on the field and his classroom are outstanding. Both these recipients were named as our Foxboro High School representative to the Hockomock League Scholar Athlete and were recognized at a banquet in early May. Our male recipient was captain of the soccer team, hockey team, and lacrosse team. Our male outstanding scholar athlete is Carter Davis. Our female recipient was also a three-sport captain in field hockey, winter track, and spring track. She too was named as a Hockomock League Scholar Athlete. She will be attending Bates College next year. Our MIAA Outstanding Scholar Athlete female is Jennifer Krupski. I'm almost there. Our next award is the National Federation of High Schools Awards of Excellence. This is given to a student athlete who demonstrates leadership, skill, and respect for opposing players while on the playing field. Our male recipient was captain of the football team, was selected as a Hockomock League and Sun Chronicle All-Star, was a member of our basketball team, and was selected as a Sun Chronicle All-Star in basketball. He will be attending Worcester State next year. Our male recipient of the National Federation of High Schools Award of Excellence is Matthew Good. Our female recipient for the National Federation of High Schools Awards was captain of the soccer team, was a member of the winter track team, and this spring tried her hand at lacrosse. She'll be attending Boston College in the fall. Our female recipient for the National Federation of High Schools Award of Excellence is Catherine Walker. The next award is the Class of 2007 Outstanding Athlete. Our male recipient was a captain of the football team, a Sun Chronicle All-Star, a Hockomock League All-Star, led our team to Super Bowl victory and our win against Mansfield, beating three undefeated teams in a row. He was captain of the basketball team that made it to the quarterfinals in the Division III South basketball tournament. Our most outstanding athlete, male student athlete, is Drew Conley. Our female recipient of the Class of 2000 Outstanding Athlete was a captain of our field hockey team, was a Sun Chronicle and Hockomock League All-Star in field hockey, was a member of our basketball team that went again to the quarterfinals in Division II South basketball tournament, was captain of the softball team, and was selected as an All-Hockomock League selection to the All-Star team in softball. Our most outstanding athlete, female, Mariella Roma. And last but not least, the Alvin Stewart Spirit Award. This is given to a student who displays the most school spirit, both on the playing field and as a spectator for his classmates. He participated in cross country, winter track, and lacrosse. And when he wasn't doing that, it wasn't too much to see him walk around with a blue F on his chest at a football game or have his face painted blue and gold at a pep rally. The recipient for the Alvin Stewart Spirit Award is Michael Garrity. I almost forgot the recipients of the U.S. Army Awards. Could you come back up? I have other awards that the U.S. Army has presented you as well. So could Eddie and Kara please come back up? Now I'd like to introduce Captain Christine Hart of the United States Air Force, giving out an award from the Air Force.
I'm Captain Christine Hart. It is a pleasure for me to be here today to represent the United States Air Force and to present this Air Force ROTC scholarship offer to Richard Jackson. The competition was especially tough this year, with approximately 10,000 high school students from across the country applying for scholarships, and we are very selective in awarding these scholarships. He is joining a very special and select group of young adults. The majority of Air Force ROTC scholarships cover full tuition, provide for books, and pay most fees, as well as a monthly stipend. The end result of this Air Force ROTC scholarship is an officer's commission in the United States Air Force. So on behalf of Brigadier General Ronnie Hawkins, Jr., Commander, Air Force Officer of Sessions and Training Schools, I would like to extend a hearty congratulations and the certificate of recognition to Richard Joseph Jackson, Jr.
At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. George Morrison to present the Foxboro Rotary Club Scholarship. Mr. Morrison.
Good evening, everyone. You are all winners, by the way. On behalf of the Foxboro Rotary Club, we want to congratulate you on your graduation from my school. The Rotary's motto is service above self. This means that Rotarians all over the world take time out of their busy schedules to volunteer on community and international projects. So as you go out into the world, take the time to give back. In keeping with our tradition of our club giving each student a graduation gift, we have these unusual ultimate survival kit. In that survival kit, you will have a can opener, a butterfly screw wrench, a ruler, a can cover remover, a knife edge, a cap opener, three position wrench, and a magnifying glass, and a mini screwdriver and a compass. What else could you need? So throw this in your backpack, in your glove compartment, in your suitcase. And each time you use the kit, and you'll see the words on it, service above self, we want you to ask yourself, what have I done to give back to humanity? Thank you. And we'll be handing them out as you come, as you file out, we'll be on either side. And George Morrison and Charlie Masterson and Cheryl Nightingale will be there to hand them out. Thank you.
I would now like to introduce Lauren Vermette, our senior speaker.
Good evening. On this day, I ask you to all look back 4 years ago when we sat in the gymnasium of the Ahern School having our own graduation from middle school. Look how much we've grown up since then. Coming in freshman year, we thought we were invincible. We had so much freedom compared to what we were used to. Each of us in our own little cliques was trying to find ourselves. My sophomore year, I had the privilege to participate in a trip to Rome and Paris, a trip that I will never forget. 40 American girls trying to find their way around Europe, we were obviously in for some trouble. I remember walking down the streets of Rome with the breathtaking image of the Colosseum peeking behind the modern city structures, thinking this is so not like Foxboro, and I loved it for that. It wasn't the small town where everyone knew your business. Cut to 4 days later, after an overnight train ride from hell, I'm walking back to the hotel after lunch on a busy street of Paris with my best friends. Thinking we were invincible, we figured no one would dare touch us on a busy street in broad daylight. Boy, were we wrong. In an instant, the five of us matured. It happened in slow motion. I was the last person in the group as we sauntered down the street. I felt like I was in a movie. This young man tried to take my friend's purse while his friends, a short distance away, laughed at the stupid American girls. Luckily, Foxboro breeds good athletes, and she held on tight to that purse, and he gave up. Instantly, it was reality again. We ran as fast as we could, screaming and crying, praying we could just be in that small town where everyone knew your business. We wanted everyone to know what had just happened. Fortunately, no one was hurt, but only shocked into a new level of maturity. The following day, on our way to the Louvre, I recall crossing a street with this group of 40 rowdy small-town girls talking about the club for that night. Now, it may have been the lack of sleep or the new European diet to which I never got accustomed to, but I remember turning to my friends and saying, you know what, guys, living your life is like crossing a street. You can just sit back and watch as everyone ventures to the other side, wondering if you should cross or not, or you can be that person who proceeds with determination, caution, and the will to meet what's on the other side. They looked at me in awe. They were baffled by what I had just said. Their response was, wow, Lauren, you're kind of right. But of course they had to add, you need some sleep. But in all seriousness, that trip brought light into my eyes. As much as I have said, I hate this town. I hate how everyone knows what happens Saturday night come third block. I've come to realize, as many of you will someday if you have not yet, that we wouldn't want it any other way. We were fortunate enough to grow up in a town where the thing we hated the most was the gossip, not the violence or the other immense crimes issues which plagued many other towns or cities. Now here we are today. Those small cliques have dissolved over time into one giant bond in which we all share. If I was able to go back and tell those young, naive freshmen that you'd be friends with that person, or that he actually turned out to be his best friend, you would have laughed directly in my face. But that's life. We learn to grow up with each other. Actually, we have all learned from one another. We comforted each other when a loved one died. We shared and celebrated the glory of championships. And now today we share, for one of the few times we have left together, this immeasurable feeling of satisfaction. And now I ask you to look back at all the roads you've chosen to cross. Each and every one of you decided to move ahead and make a friend, find a hobby that you will cherish forever, or more importantly, discover who you really are. But in the end, I'd like to thank each and every one of you, faculty and fellow classmates, for being there with me to cross those roads to get me where I am, not only today, but where I'll be in 5, 10, even 20 years from now. Thank you for the memories, and good luck to you with any street which you may have to cross. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Delaney.
Thank you, Lauren. Before I announce the scholarships for tonight and introducing some folks to give them out with me, Mr. Sibley and Dr. Katz, Jordan entered the halls of this high school a Stoughton Black Knight, but he will always be remembered in our hearts and our minds as a Foxboro Warrior. I also went to this building in September for the first time in 10 years with a lot less gray hair than I have now. This senior class, I've enjoyed it immensely, and I look forward to graduation day. You've rejuvenated me. You really have. I mean that. After 14 years, I was losing a little luster, and to come back and get it back, I truly mean that. I didn't enjoy every day I left here, but I look forward to the next day. So again, we look forward to Sunday. It gives me great pleasure to present the Ahern Cornish Scholarship
to a Foxboro High School graduating senior. This scholarship was established by the Ahern Student Council and Mr. and Mrs. Connors to recognize a graduating Foxboro High School senior who successfully balanced academic pursuits with extracurricular and community activities and will major in the field of medical research, medicine, or science. This year, I am pleased to present the scholarship on behalf of the committee to Mr. Donald Sally. At this point, it gives me great pleasure to introduce another Foxboro High School alumni, Mr. Ernie Guy, to present the Edwin C. Guy Memorial Scholarship. Mr. Guy.
Mr. Heinricker informed me that they reinforced the stage as I approached the dais. Thank you. As Mr. Delaney said, well, actually, it's kind of hard for me to refer to him as Mr. Delaney. As Bert said, my name is Ernie Guy, and I am from the class of 1974, and I'm here to give the scholarship that we instituted in my father's memory 6 years ago. But before I do that, it occurred to me tonight as I see all these young people approach the stage and get their accolades that I'm getting old. Between my hot flashes and the fact that there's not even a member of the staff who was here when I taught high school here in 1979, let alone any of the students left. So I do feel like I'm getting on in years. Mabel Burrell was my one of my first grade teachers. Charlie Taylor was a superintendent of schools at the time. Jake Ahern was my first high school principal for 2 years. Vinnie Igo, well, you know, Vinnie was just everywhere. And if you, the young lady tonight who said if you had told her 4 years ago that she'd be up here giving an award, well, I'd say if you had told me 33 years ago that I'd be up here giving out a scholarship in my father's name, you could have knocked me over with a feather. But more importantly, if you would have told me 33 years ago that Bert Delaney and Joe Heinricher would be running the school, I'd have just laughed at you. All right, well, this scholarship is dedicated in the memory of my dad. My other family members couldn't be here tonight because it's my mom's 75th birthday, and they're home celebrating, and I will leave here soon to join them. But this award is given to a male and female student athlete here at Foxboro High that kind of exemplifies the esprit, the team spirit, the comradeship, and the enthusiasm that it takes to be a Foxboro Warrior. Because anybody who knew my father knew that he was the consummate Foxboro Warrior fan. So without further ado, it gives me great pleasure to announce that the female recipient of the $2,000 Eddie Guy Scholarship for the class of 2007 is Miss Brenna Gray. Now the male recipient, I've known this young man for a number of years. He is a true leader and a true gentleman. He's already been feted tonight, but it does give me great pleasure to award the male recipient of the Eddie Guy Scholarship for $2,000 for the class of 2007 to Mr. Brian Johns. Come up to the stage. And now I'd like to introduce Miss Winifred Darlington for her scholarship. Thank you.
Good evening, and my congratulations to the Foxboro High School graduates of 2007. I'm very honored to be here and be part of your class night. Many years ago, six of my children graduated from Foxboro High School. They were all very happy and very successful, thanks to the teachers. I'm here to represent the trustees of the Easter Chapter, Order of the Eastern Star, and to award three scholarships. We had six applications, and they were absolutely excellent. We had a most difficult time trying to decide. So we usually give two $2,000 scholarships. This year, we decided to give three. Hopefully, next year, it will be all six. All these students, all applications, excels in scholastic, leadership, and community service. And we extend our sincere wishes and congratulations to all of you. I now would like to present the scholarships to Christine McDonald. We're very proud of you. Hope you will do that.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. And to Parker Millender. Very proud of you. We hope you will do well.
Thank you.
I would now like to present, introduce Miss Barbara Eaton.
On behalf of the World Language Department, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the Laura Remillard Scholarship, which was established in memory of Laura Remillard, a former teacher and department head of the World Language Department. This scholarship is awarded to a graduating Foxboro High School senior who has excelled in world languages. It's my pleasure to present the Laura Remillard Scholarship to Catherine Walker. Mr. Dave Watkins.
Good evening once again. Father, teacher, assistant principal, principal. Bill Palladino was a man of quiet strength and conviction. He was a man of honor and integrity. Bill was humble, he was kind, and he was giving. Those of us who were fortunate enough to know him loved him. In 2000, Bill lost his battle with ALS. Each year at this time, we honor his memory by awarding a scholarship to a member of the senior class who possesses the characteristics we found so endearing in Bill. The criterion for this award is rather simple. We're looking for an outstanding person who is service-oriented. This year's winner has spent more than 250 hours over the past 4 years raising funds for ALS research. She started as a co-chair of the donations committee for the Sharon Timlin Memorial Race and has for the past 2 years been the corporate sponsor coordinator for the same event, helping to raise more than $200,000 for research. One teacher described this young lady as having a great work ethic and attitude. Another said she was an excellent student and a great person who was very respectful and responsible. The winner of the 7th annual William Palladino Scholarship in the amount of $2,000 is Alyssa Gaudette. Now I'd like to introduce Mr. Delaney once again.
This next scholarship goes to a deserving senior of the class of 2007. It is the Helen and Blanche Stark Memorial Scholarship. Recipients of this scholarship must be Foxboro residents and must be enrolled in or accepted to an accredited nursing program. Tonight, with great pleasure and honor, I'd like to present this scholarship to Catherine Walker. Also, three former scholarship winners here at FHS. Ms. Stephanie Olivo, 2004, Ms. Amy Whitney, 2005, and Ms. Sarah Goshen, 2006, will also receive another year of scholarship as they continue their education in the field of nursing. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Ms. Mary Kane, representing the Catholic Daughters of America. Ms. Kane.
Good evening. I am very impressed by the class of 2007. With all the awards and all the scholarships, you should be very proud of yourselves, and the teachers should be proud of all the students. Congratulations to all of you. My name is Mary Kane, and I am the state chairman of the Massachusetts Catholic Daughters of the Americas. Our scholarship is awarded to a senior who is in excellent academic standing, is involved in numerous school and community activities, and also is related to an active member of the Catholic Daughters. This year's $1,200 scholarship of the Catholic Daughters of the Americas goes to Kristen McDonald. And now I would like to introduce Miss Lori Garrigan.
Good evening and congratulations to the class of 2007. I was a 1981 graduate and I'm here tonight to present my parents' memorial scholarship. Although they are not here in the physical sense, they are here in my heart, and I know they would be very proud of this next recipient. It is with great honor and pride for myself and my family to award the Sandra M. and David J. Henry Jr. Memorial Scholarship to my daughter, Nicole Marie Triani. I'd like to introduce the next speaker, Mr. William Milholm.
It's an honor to present the first memorial scholarship in the name of John J. Ahern. I heard Mr. Guy mention him as Jake. For some of you people out there, you may remember John as a friend, not too many. Some of you may remember him as a colleague. Most of you young people only will remember him because his name is on a school. He was my principal. I'm from the class of 1968. But John was my neighbor. And you know, one of the most overlooked things at graduations is the class motto. Behind me is the class motto. Mottos usually aren't things that you just pick quickly. The class of 2007 has chosen as their motto, "In the end, it's not the years in your life that counts. It's the life in your years." John and I spent many, many days sitting on the porch of his house that he was born in 1922, which is no longer there. It's been plowed under, and there's a new house on the property. But John spent 25 years in the Foxboro High School school system, 15 of them as a principal. Now, most of the students here are worthy of this scholarship. But John always told me, and I was one of those students, there are students who are going to make it without the help of parents or teachers because they are stellar. But there are people who, if given a little chance, a little support, a little encouragement, a little money, they can make it. John always told me he wasn't interested in helping those who could make it, only those that he thought he could make a difference in their life. The class president today mentioned that Jordan had gifted his organs, but he's also gifted each one of you here something. It's his memory. And it's the memory that should go along with your motto. Every day, live your life as if everybody around you is important. Because when it comes to the end of your life, it won't matter what you drove or what you owned. It'll be the memory in the hearts that people carry. Many people love John J. Ahern. And I carry his memory. And I can guarantee, as a former member of Foxboro High, who put four kids through this place, who married the girl he met in sophomore year, here, that you will always have memories of Foxboro High. You will travel this world and you will meet people who are graduates of Foxboro High. High school friendships will be with you forever. So I am proud to present this first scholarship, and it's a memorial because we are memorializing people who are not here with us. But they will live in our hearts, in our scholarships, and in the lives that these scholarships change. I am honored to give this first scholarship to Caitlin McGuire. I would like to introduce the Spear family, please.
Good evening, everybody. This is our first year handing out the Spear Family Foundation scholarship. The scholarship's based on community involvement, academic achievement, and strong personal character. We received two applications this year, and with my family, we reviewed both of them, and also two had a tough time making a decision. So we tried to decide and came up with a resolution was to give two scholarships. So the first scholarship is someone that has been up here tonight already, but we'd like to award her with a scholarship for $3,000, and that's Lauren Vermetti. The second application, after reviewing it, also had the same similar traits, and we feel compelled to also recognize this person for a $2,000 scholarship, and that would be Kimberly Clark. Thank you. And the next person to present is Jeffrey Theodos. The next two scholarships are in memory of two, I would say, legendary school administrators in the town of Foxboro. A lot of the younger folks are not going to recognize these names, but anyone over the age of my age of 30, you'll recognize them. They're in memory of George Bedrosian and Rusty Loader, longtime administrators in this town. On behalf of the Taylor School and the Taylor School PTO, it is my pleasure to present the George Bedrosian Memorial Scholarship to Cara Deedy. Also, on behalf of the Taylor School and the Taylor School PTO, it is with my pleasure to present the Rustin Lodi Memorial Scholarship to Brittany Madden. I'd like to introduce Michael back to the stage. Mike.
I'd like to have my fellow class officers join me on stage.
Mrs. Relevan and Mrs. Foyt, we would like to start off by apologizing that at every one of our dances there were not enough songs played for you. I know you guys tried. Sorry. But thank you so much for everything you've done the last 4 years. Your time and energy has been noticed throughout our class. Everything from car washes to yard sales to making countless flag pins for Founders Day to prom and to graduation day. This class would not have been the same without you.
Miss Releva, honestly, without you, this class would have fallen to pieces. Thank you so much for everything you have done for the class of 2007. Without your help, and of course, room 108, nothing would have ever gotten done. We will always have the memories we had, the good ones and the bad. Whether it be driving around for hours trying to find that perfect place for prom, or dancing in the hallway, we will miss you very much.
Miss Hoyt, I just want to say I know for a fact I wouldn't be right here if it wasn't for you. I'd definitely still be a freshman. So I want to thank you for everything you've done for our class and especially for being my second mother in school. So thank you very much.
At this time, I would like to acknowledge the people here tonight who have been dedicating long hours to prepare for our all-night graduation party to be held on June 10th. These are our parents, family members, friends, and chaperones who have organized the planning of our party. They've worked diligently to raise money, solicit donations and raffle prizes, and they've dedicated long hours in making decorations and props to transform this gym into a night for all of us to remember, and most importantly, to keep us all safe. I would like to acknowledge the following people. If you are present when I say your name, please stand to be acknowledged and remain standing. Co-chairpersons Linda Roddenbush and Jane Pine. Fundraising Julie Conley and Carol McKeon. Decorating Mara Carcitti and Annette Jackson. Chaperones Bruce and Rosemary Storr. Publicity Barbara Robbins. Setup and breakdown Peggy Grundle. Raffles Jan Kayani. Refreshments Connie Stather and Margie Minkler. I would also like to acknowledge all the other volunteers involved in the all-night party. Would those people please stand now? You know who you are. So. There you go. They certainly deserve all our applause and thanks. Without them, our party would not be possible. On behalf of the entire class of 2007, thank you all for your gift of time. This brings class night 2007 to a close. I hope that you all join us in the cafeteria for refreshments. Thank you.